performed might be appropriate, Board, but warmly welcome you all this evening to the final Mass this evening of our parish family mission. And we're delighted this evening to welcome Bishop Dennis here this evening to celebrate the Mass with us. Bishop Dennis was part of the family of our diocese for many years. He was ordained just a year before me in 1998, native of Slane, and served in Mullingar Parish and also St Mary's Scotland for many years before being elected as Bishop of Kildare and Loughlin. So we're delighted to welcome Bishop Dennis among us this evening as back to the family of our own diocese this evening. But we're all part of a bigger family, the family of God, the family of the Church. And it's as part of that family this evening that we come to pray together, to be enriched together, to be nourished together, to celebrate together, to sing together, and to pray together. So as part of that larger family, the family of God, let us join now with Declan in the opening hymn of our Mass this evening, Bind Us Together, Lord, on page 51 in our booklets.
the arts end of college when I was studying BA in the Louvre. So it's lovely to be here, it's lovely to hear you talk as family, because we come as family. And we know often our families are broken. Brothers fall out with each other over a neighbor of land. Neighbors fall out over a wall, over noise, over dogs barking. Sisters fall out over some little issue around jealousy, around attention. And yet still family is so important. Because there are great graces that you life brought out. A baby born in the night. There are great graces in healing. And someone who is feeling ill is lifted up and supported by the family. And we all grow in together so well. The word meeting of families, which we hope Pope Francis will be present and accompany us during that visit in August next year, is a tremendous moment for us to hear him talk about family, about life, and about how we might live our lives in 2020. We gather in prayer, we bless water. As we bless the water, we renew our own baptismal journey. The journey that has brought us here over four Monday nights of February. Or more important journey that will take us out of here to make a difference in our family and in our lives. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless us water his creator, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Almighty ever living God, who will that through water, the fountain of life and the source of purification, even souls should be cleansed and receive the gift of eternal life, be pleased, we pray, to bless this water, by which we seek protection of this your day, O Lord. Renew the living spring of your grace within us, and grant that by this water we may be defended from all ills of spirit and body. So approach you with hearts made clean, and worthy to receive your salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. He who honors his mother is like someone amassing a fortune. Whoever respects his father will be happy with children of his own. He shall be heard on the day when he breaks. Long life comes to him who honors his father. He who sets his mother at ease is showing obedience to the Lord. My son, support your father in his old age. Do not grieve him during his life. Even if his mind should fail, show him sympathy. Do not despise him in your health and strength. For kindness to a father shall not be forgotten, but will serve as reparation for your sins. The word of the Lord.
Always be thankful. Let the message of Christ in all its richness
find a home with you. Teach each other and advise each other in all wisdom. With gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms and hymns and inspired songs to God. And never say or do anything except the name of the Lord Jesus. Give thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, give way to your husbands as you shun in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and treat them with gentleness. Children, be obedient to your parents always, because that is what will please the Lord. Parents, never drive your children to resentment, or you will make them feel frustrated. The word of the Lord. Please stand for us.
Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the peace of Christ reign in your hearts, and let the message of Christ find a home with you. Praise and honour to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, may you cleanse my heart and my lips, and I will heartily proclaim your holy gospel. The Lord be with you. Reading the holy gospel according to St. Luke. When the day came for them to be purified as laid down by the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. And when they had done everything that the law of the Lord required, they went back to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. Meanwhile, the child Jesus grew to maturity, and he was filled with wisdom, and God's favour was with him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Nothing makes sense unless we can connect with family.
I had 7 confirmations in the last week. I have 5, 6 more this week in the Snowd, Carlow and Kildare Leash. And I invite all the young people to write me a letter, a personal letter, not by the teacher, not by the parent, by the young person themselves. Just like our 4th service tonight, we're making confirmation only in a couple of weeks' time. Every one of the letters without fail talk about, my daddy does this, my nanny does that, my sister is that, my brother is that, I love my gran. I love my granddad. Family is very special. I think the biggest challenge for us when we're making families is, because on this very day, the 26th of February, in 6 months' time, it will be the 26th of August. Please God, we'll be joining together in the Phoenix Park, probably, for a mass with hundreds of thousands of others. Pope Francis will then be on a plane back to Rome. What will we be left with at the end of 4, 5, 6 days? What will be the legacy? I think, and I hope and pray, something that will strengthen family life in our dioceses, in our parishes. And yet I'm aware family is very, very simple for so many and complicated for others. I think of the ad for 123.ie on the radio about the dodgy shower door. Do you know that one? The father is in the shower or half in, half out of it, and the daughter kind of bends into the bathroom and then the father shouts out, "Can a man have no peace in his own home?" Which the daughter responds, "I want therapy from this family." We all come tonight with dodgy shower toys. We all have a little kind of a latch that's not just perfect. So what's our definition of family? Family, Pope Francis tells us in the words that he sees, the joy of love, is God's greatest masterpiece. And he warns us about what he calls the culture of the ephemeral, where everything is disposable. Everyone uses and throws away. Everyone takes and breaks. Everyone exploits and squeezes to the last drop sometimes in society today. Like, you know, the Bonnie Valley honey jar. You squeeze the last bit out of it. Sometimes as parents, sometimes as families, we can feel squeezed to bits, can't we? We do our best. We climb up one hill and to realise there's another one just beyond it. Family means everything to me. When both my parents died, my mother died in 2010, my father died in 2006. There's no doubt the heart of the family goes. My brothers and my sisters are wonderful. They do their very best. And we all do our very best. But it's never the same. Parents are central in our lives. I felt the death particularly of my second parent, my mother, when I walked into her home. And our home was located in the very centre of a farmyard, where all of life passed by that door. Mama slipped into eternity on the morning of the Icelandic ash. Do you remember the Icelandic ash that grounded all the planes? But she was talking with my brother, he was bringing her up to the bathroom or something, after 10 o'clock tea, after the usual ritual that happens in every farmhouse. And she still was fascinated with this Icelandic ash. What was that all about? And what was it when she was gone into eternity? It was just after Easter. Her death's so different to Dada's. Dada lived for 4 years with the effect of a stroke. 4 years in many respects trying to die. And yet his body was so strong. I remember the Sunday evening after Mama died so well, returning home, turning the latch key, it was a bastard lock. I remember every moment of opening that door still to this day. The Annie Cooper was out. The chair at the end of the table was empty. The tea towel was in the very same place I left it a few days earlier. You see, our home was just like every other normal home. When the oil ran out, the cooker, the urn on oil, there was always a problem. Dad blamed Mama, Mama blamed Dad. It was your turn. You should have rang men's control you. There was no one to make that call. The cooker has never really been since. It was at home we learned to pray. There was no do this in memory or bridge programs. We
recently went to Mass.
Last was the car, usually myself. I sat on a handbrake.
Talk about health and safety.
Memories of Mass in my younger days were focused on the celebrant. We knew the priest at home. He called to our house. He visited the farm. He knew us by name. Coming from a home where faith is very natural as a blessing, but not something I ever take for granted. I think of my mother's prayer book, which I still have beside my own bed. She loved Margaret de Porres. Dad's second name was Kirk, a deacon who worked with St. Patrick in Slane. Growing up on a farm gave me and my two brothers, Christy and Leo, and two sisters, Anne and Dolores, a super appreciation of the Creator God. Seeds are sown. They grow, they're harvested, but they must be minded. Cows are milked twice a day. 365 days, my father would remind us, including Christmas Day. I'm not sure how we cope with the apps and technology that his grandchildren would now use to great effect on the farm today, like geo-measure area calculator, when the world spread fertilizer. He wouldn't be able to cope. Bad pattern app for how to do the fields all the way. Herod March. A farm gives you a seasonal cycle that allows for a deeper appreciation of God. Light and darkness, birth and death. Coming into the world, going out of the world. I remember the Christmas, a neighbour's God meant huge destruction on the sheep, on lambs. I remember the package arrived from the United States. It was clothes from older American cousins. They had outgrown their sizes. And they were as welcome today as a trip to Tiki and Max would be. I think of the nights we prayed together, the rosary. As children, one brother kicking the other, making them laugh. And the Sacred Heart lamp in the kitchen, and everything hanging around the lamp. Everything was put there. When the dental appointment was due, the priest envelopes, the scapulars. I often wonder what my parents would have made my appointment as a bishop. My father would worry for me, he always worried. He worried I'd overdo it, he was right, I always overdo it. But in a certain perspective, I said yes. Well, I would do my best. Mother would be sorry I was going too far from home. Because always it was a kind of a deal I'd never go on the missions. Never be far from Slane, from Mead, from Westmead. She'd be worried I was too far away from the trees I looked to climb, the fields I looked to walk in. And the animals I enjoyed as well. Because despite all of life, you always have interest beyond being a priest. Beyond being a bishop and farming is always something close to my heart. And it's interesting. When I got a phone call from the Nunciature in April 2013, I left the Nunciature with news that I could share nowhere. And the same has happened. Dermot Farrell over in Dunboyne, who goes off to be made Bishop of Ossory in 2 weeks' time. And in that early stage, you could tell nobody, not even family. And you carry into something that will profoundly change your life, your parish, and your priorities. So family is having someone to check in with for all of us. Family is where you can kick off your shoes and chill out, even if there's a whole new songs. Family is where you can chill be by yourself and be yourself. I thank God tonight for family. I thank God for the friends who keep me grounded and take me a bit easier times. I thank God for the priests, the people of my old diocese, who have become my new family, and the priests and people of need who will always remain close to my heart. A mission evening like this evening helps us to appreciate family life. For all of us, our families are much more like the Simpsons than the Walters. It's complicated. Pope Francis, who I love, says, the family is the nearest hospital, first school for the young, the best home for the elderly. He said, sometimes planes can fly. Children can be a headache. How much happier our lives would be if we understood the importance of the words please, thank you, sorry. In this messy but grace-filled reality, family life is lived out at every parish level, including entering the ground of life. Our parishes must today be outbound, not inward-looking. Our parishes must be missionary, in the outreach to the broken, the excluded, those who feel uncertain of their place in society. When I was a priest in Drogheda, a parish priest there,
Often people would say to me, Father, she's on the far side. And I always wonder what the far side was. I tell another comic strip by Gary Larson, where it was a stone's throw away from the River Boyne, from another diocese, from another county. But they say he's a Dulygate man. It meant he never ventured far from Dulygate. A parish defines who we are, who we play our club football with, where our children go to school, and ultimately, where we be laid to rest. Parishes are primary for all of us. The word meaning families is going to let us reflect on parish, reflect on family, reflect on what it is to have faith in 2018. It begins on the 21st of August in every local diocese with the celebration of the cathedral. It continues then for 3 days in August, on the 22nd, 23rd, 24th, in the audience for a congress which will reflect in different workshops, different ways of being family. Then there'll be a festival of families in Croke Park, most likely. And hopefully Pope Francis will be there. In the middle of Croke Park, sitting in a settee with families chosen from different areas of Ireland, different ethnic minorities, different ethnic groups. And finally, please call the Mass, most likely again if Pope is here with us in the Phoenix Park. People would say, will it be as big as 1979? Hands up those who remember 1979. 48%. It won't be as big as 1979. You know why? Health and safety. You know yourself, trying to get people in there, not to worry about ingress and egress. I'm on the board organising these things, and I'm getting all kinds of planners, meetings, telling you, we can't have so many, we're going to be the same number of people if we're in the program. The important thing is, book early. Get your ticket to be there in the audience. Volunteer. Details are on the back of the church. Register. Pray for the success of it. It's interesting that international families are booking in their thousands. So make sure that you yourself are part of the great gathering. Some people will say, we're too busy, too many things happening. This is an event that will shape the Irish Church for many years. We have hugely suffered from the darkness of abuse, of scandal, the shadows of life that fall across all of us, church leaders, church ministers, people who care about their faith, people who love their church, all of us, and most of all the victims are the ones who suffer. But there's a certain aspect that the word meaning of families gives us an opportunity to redefine our faith, our family, in an environment where all families are welcome. May the Lord bless all of you this evening. May the Lord enrich all of us as we reflect more on family life. And may the Lord strengthen us as we continue to reflect on the importance of family in our parish, in our diocese, and in our country.
Family mission, may all the families be renewed in faith, prayer. joy. Lord, hear us. We give thanks to God for the great gift of life. May the gift of life be always cherished, valued, and cared for from its very beginning to its natural end.
We pray for our teachers and guardians. May they work with the priests and the teachers of our parish in the building of the faith of our people. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our parish, family, and community. May all who work to build community spirit, enhance community life, be strengthened by their faith in God, and continue to be inspired by examples of Jesus' life of service to theirs. Lord, hear us.
We pray for family members who are sick, those ill at home, in nursing homes and hospitals. We pray for doctors, nurses, home help, and family members who care for the sick and housebound. Lord, hear us.
We pray for family members who are away from home, those living and working abroad. May they find warmth, hospitality, and welcome wherever they are this night. Lord, hear us.
We pray for family members who have died. We pray for deceased parents, grandparents, and children. We remember especially those who have died recently. May all our dead be raised to a new and everlasting life. Lord, hear us.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accepting your goodness, these our prayers, O Lord, and set free from worldly attractions those who allow to serve the heavenly mysteries through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that ourselves tonight shall give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you, countless angels, as in one voice of praise, be it saved. Holy, holy, holy Lord God, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to the setting, your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously made holy, these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night of his betrayal, he himself took bread, giving you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you
but they are passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
In this we wish to the Narragansett Bay School of Scholars of Building, just need to stand and pray for now.
I'm
72.
Especially for leading you through last week, and especially to
thank Bishop Dennis, who you can realise has a very busy schedule with so many confirmations and all the different activities and part of the planning group for the board meeting with families. But thank him especially for coming to be with us here this evening for his beautiful reflective talk, his personal talk on what family means to him, especially, and all the experience of family that all of us can relate so easily with here this evening. So thank you, Bishop Dennis, and we wish you a continued blessing in your ministry. We're glad to have you back with us this evening once again. And thanks for your support and your helpfulness and your generosity by simply being here this evening. So thank you, guys.
They may be constant in making supplication to you and sincere in love.